Sneak Peek Restorations, and we're back to business as usual with another video for you guys.
I like that.
Back to business as usual.
What's good, everybody? It's your boy Benny G Buckets.
And George, aka Stitch.
And we are back to business as usual.
Today, guys, we're gonna be working on a pair of shoes that we're gonna customize. However, we're gonna switch up the format and do something just a little bit different.
So basically, the shoes that we have right now are an all red Nike ID Cortez, and all we're gonna do is make the tongue red.
While we do that, we are gonna walk you guys through the process, and we're gonna give you guys tips and advice for all our customizers and painters out there. If you are interested in customizing your own shoes, this video should help you out a lot.
So let's go ahead and get started.
All right, guys, so as we said earlier, we are going to get into a little bit more depth with our customization on this video. What we have in store for you today, guys, is pretty simple, but also really beneficial to all our customizers out there. We're going to be changing the color of the tongue from white to red. So to get started, the very first step, Ben is going to unlace the shoes. As he does that, I'm gonna tell you what we're gonna be doing. So you can't really tell from this angle, but the tongue is a sort of mesh material. And if we were to just paint it with regular paints, the tongue would get really hard, and that's not good quality from customizers. So what we want to do is we want to give you a tip, some advice on how to avoid that. So we're going to go ahead and finish unlacing these shoes, and then we'll get back to you as soon as they're unlaced. All right, guys, so as you can see, I have some materials down here. I have two paints. That is Chili Red from Angelus. It's acrylic paint, and we also have Red from Angelus. As you guys can tell, we have some brushes as well and a mixing container. Most people think, oh, this is perfectly fine. This is all you need to paint some shoes because all you need is paint. However, as I said earlier, the tongue is mesh, and so we can't just go ahead and paint it with regular paint or else it would get hard and sticky, and customers do not like that. So we need one more material for this project. What we're gonna incorporate here is GAC 900. This is a heat set fabric painting medium that helps and keep the mesh soft. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and start off with the chili red paint because it is lighter. And then as I continue to mix the paints, I will add more and more drops of red to find the perfect shade. Once I do that, I'm going to add a 1-to-1 ratio of GAC 900. So that way we can go ahead and keep the mesh soft.
While he does that, as you guys can tell, these Cortezes are brand new. However, they do have some dust particles and some leavings from the laces. So while they don't need to be cleaned, we can't have these particles on the surface. So he's gonna mix the paint, and I'm gonna use a dry brush just to remove these particles.
All right, guys, so back to me now. As you guys can see, I am slowly removing the cap. For a lot of customizers out there, you get really eager about wanting to get started with your project. However, you want to do this step really slowly. Reason I say this is because there have been many incidents where we mess up and we spill paint. In every single video that we have these two boards under us. And as you can see, they are really painted up and have a lot of marks on them. They did not start this color, obviously. These markers that we placed are all... We're all black, so this all comes through mistake, and so this reason why I say this is because sometimes the paints have brushes under them. This one does not, but it's smart to remove them slowly. All right, so what I'm gonna do now, I don't want too much paint because we're not painting a big area, and I'm also gonna add 1-to-1 ratio of GAC, so I'm gonna go ahead and keep my portion small. I'm gonna go ahead and add about 5 to 10 drops of chili red and test out the paint color on a piece of paper. Let's go ahead and do that first. All right, so before I add my paint to my mixing container, first what I want is I wanna bring the shoe back into play. Reason I do this is so I could see the color of the upper and we could go ahead and match it with the color of the mesh. Next, I need something to test the paint on. So I'm gonna go ahead and add some paper right here so that way I can test it right there. Now I can go ahead and start adding paint to my mixing container. As I said, guys, 5 to 10 drops. Only, as you can tell, this is not a large amount. The reason I do that is because right now all I'm doing is testing, and I can find a good ratio. That's perfect. Okay, that was 6. It was a little more than I wanted, but that'll do. All right. As you, I don't know if you guys, if I got it on camera, I'm sorry. However, as you can see now, I am wiping the excess paint off the side of the container, or off the side of the paint jar. Reason I'm doing this is because when you put the cap back on, that paint will dry and it'll be hard to remove for the next time. So I'm gonna go ahead and remove that and then place it back into my mixing container. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take chili red straight up before I mix it, grab a little bit and test it out first. So here's my paint, here's my paper, and all I'm gonna do is put a little brush strokes. The paint looks really full here, guys, but don't get it twisted. That's not how it's gonna look when you paint on shoes. It's not gonna look that full. Okay, I'm gonna let it dry for a little bit, then I'm gonna go ahead and add some more coats just so it could darken up. And we could get the real effect of how of what the color looks like here. Okay, we'll give that about 5 seconds because it dries very fast on paper. It does not do the same on shoes. All right, that looks about fine. And go ahead and add the third coat just so we could get a really good idea. All right, guys, now what we're gonna do is we are gonna go ahead, and I should have done this on the edge of the paper. However, this would be fine. I'm just gonna fold this corner right here just so I can get it as close as I can to the actual upper, and we can test to see how the colors match. So I'm gonna go ahead and add them up right here, and as you guys can see, they are very close. However, the upper on the shoe is a little bit darker. So what we're gonna need to do is we're gonna need to incorporate some of our regular red. The reason we do this is because we wanna add a darker effect on the paper, on the, on the mixture. Okay, so here's my red, I already took it off. And now I'm just going to add a couple of drops. All right, so now you can see this mixture is just a little bit darker, which is exactly what we wanted. So I'm gonna go ahead and fold that up again, just like the first time. And now I'm going to compare it with my upper. Now, I don't know about that, but it is actually a lot closer than it was before. How are you feeling about it, Ben?
I think it needs to be a little darker.
All right, the man has spoken. It needs to be a little bit darker, so that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna add a couple more drops. All we're gonna be adding here is one more drop, guys. I'm gonna have to be real careful about this because I am keeping my ratio. That is very important to know how many drops you have put. So we're gonna go ahead and let this dry real quick for a little bit, and then we're gonna go ahead and test it out. Alright guys, as I hold it up to the surface, it looks a lot better and I really like it. I don't know if the camera is giving it its real justice, but I think that's the mixture with what we're gonna go with. Alright, so now that that is done, we're gonna go ahead and get a little bit more paints, and we're gonna do that on time lapse just to, for the sake of time, and then we'll get back to you with the next step. Let's do it. Alright guys, so our mixture is now complete. I'm gonna hold it up to the camera now. As you can tell, it is very watery. Reason for this is because we added our GAC 900. You might have been able to tell on the time lapse. You also might have not, but we did it. And so don't forget to do that. Again, it is a 1-to-1 ratio. So what we can do now, guys, is we can go ahead and get started painting. However, this picture is missing one thing. Very important when you're painting mesh, you need yourself a heat setter. This can be a blow dryer or a heat gun. We have a heat gun. So what we're gonna do now is while I paint, Ben is going to heat gun. Reason you do this is to keep the mesh soft again. Everything that we're doing today is for mesh and mesh only. All right guys, so with painting, just a couple of tips. You wanna be very careful with what you do, and precision is key all the time. What we're going to do is we're going to paint all the surrounding areas of this tongue red, but we are going to leave this Nike sign white and black. Okay, so I don't know if you guys can tell, but it is a white, it is a square looking tag. So we're gonna leave this white and black. We don't wanna touch that with our paint. However, everything else is going to be red. So what we're going to do now is we're going to go ahead and paint. All right, so what you want to do is you want to dip your paintbrush in the paint. You don't want to get too much mixture. You just want to get it on the tip of your brush. Be careful with where you're painting, because you don't want to get it again anywhere else. So I am going to paint this outer side red, but I just want to give you guys a little bit of tips on painting while being careful. So Ben is going to go ahead and focus the camera right here so you guys can get a better view. All right, and so as you guys can see, I am holding this shoe very firm. You don't want to let it go. You don't want it to be loose, and you don't want to have the area that you're painting, you don't want it to be wobbly. Also, as you guys can see, I am keeping my position with my pinky. This helps give me a better firm and a better grip on the paintbrush. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to paint very carefully. You want a steady hand, and you're just going to go down the area that you're painting without touching it. Confidence is key, guys, but you don't want to be cocky. If you're cocky and you want to go fast and, oh, I think I know how to do this, it's easy, you can go ahead and end up ruining yourself or somebody else's shoes, and you never want to do that. So just be careful, guys. Even if you're a pro, never act like you're a pro. Always act like you can mess up, because that is a possibility and that will happen. I'm only doing this to show you guys because a lot of you guys might be painting something like this. However, we are not, so I'm going to go ahead and touch it now. We are not worried about the stitches or anything like that. We are trying to get those red as well. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to paint just a little area. The reason I do this is because I do not want the paint to dry by itself. I want it to dry with a heat gun. Although this is not terrible, we want it to get set with some heat and not just regular air. I'm not going to get too close to the white, as I will do my touch-ups later. But all right, I'm almost done with this painting right here. That right there should be a big enough area, and as you guys can tell, it's not a huge area, but it is where we want to get it. All right, so now Ben is setting his heat gun up. As you guys can see, he has it on the lowest setting, and he doesn't want to get it too hot. And if you guys are painting with he's setting with a blow dryer or anything of the sort, you should be fine. All he's gonna do now is hold the airbrush about 2 to 3 inches away. I'm sorry, 1 to 2 inches away from the shoe, because he doesn't want to get it too hot, as shoes are very fragile. And he's gonna heat it up until it's dry.
Another tip with the heat gun: you don't want to leave it in one area. If you leave it in one area like this, that can cause burning. That can even cause a fire. So you want to keep it moving. And again, you don't want to put it on the highest setting. If you have a blow dryer, you don't want to put it as hot as possible, because again, that might not be good for the shoe. You could cause a fire. So after you've done it for a little bit, go ahead and fill it out. It's still a little wet, so we're going to continue to heat set it. And this is going to be the process through both tongues and for every coat we do. And again, a coat isn't going to be the whole tongue. It's only going to be a little section.
I'm glad that Ben touched on that. I want you guys to know that when you're painting a shoe, you cannot only do one coat. That is not sufficient. You can't just paint it one time and think you're done. We didn't even do that on our paper when we were testing out the paints. That's not the way you want to do it. You guys want to do at 3 to 5 coats, depending on the paint you're painting with. If it's white, you're going to want to do about 900. And if it's purple, 10,000. But for anything else, guys, the paint should cover well, and you won't need that much. You'll need about 3 to 5 coats, as I said, sometimes 7. But even if it's for mesh, you want to do multiple coats, because you want the paint to look full, and you want to get a good vibrant color when you're done. So we're going to go ahead and continue with this custom, and we're going to go ahead and finish up the rest of the custom on time lapse, because we don't want to sit here and bore you guys with our talk. And then once they are done, we're going to go ahead and show you guys the final product. But this is pretty simple. What you have to do: paint, heat set, repeat, and just do it until you're comfortable. When you're doing touch-ups, guys, just be very careful and never be too cocky. But all right, let's go ahead and finish this up and show you guys the final product. They know how we ride. Gang, gang, squad, squad. When they see us, they like, oh, God. We just getting started, hold on. Just can't go wrong. Hold up, bro, this my song. Tryna come to the show, sold out. But you
It's pure love, only one way. Push what up, nigga. Whoa. True flow, two call, a name. Tell her running bands up, I need it. Hit the club, pure love, I'm leaving. I get paid to walk through, believe it. Me and Sudi been nice, it's the go-getters. Grind hard, promise never be a broke nigga. Back talk, I talk a lot of back shit. Make cash flow, your paper really stagnant. Like Slim B, it's bands and it's MC. So back up, I need at least 10 feet. Keep 10 G's, large and he skinny's. Late night, getting neck at McKinley. Got Fendi all around my waistline. My time worth more, I don't waste time. If it ain't a milli plus, then I can't sign. Gang, gang, squad, squad, that's B-line. We finna get these millions, believe it. All
right, so y'all, that's it for today's video. As you guys can tell, this video was a little bit different from the ones we usually make. However, we did this due to requests. And so if you guys are interested in more videos like this, please comment down below and let us know. We are glad to do it. Also, guys, our contact information is down below in the description, so check that out if you ever want to get some custom work done.
And never forget, check out SBR15.com for steals and any apparel you might need. And today's quote of motivation is, every minute, every moment you spend thinking and wishing is a dollar you're missing out on. So from your boys here at Sneak Peek, Benny G Buckets.
And George A. Sticks.
It's only one way.
Maybe.
Budge, 10 years, no fans, that sucks. Who the ones that can't stand, that's us. But who the ones who got the bands, that's us. Money counter, run it up.
Whoa, before we go, guys, we just want to give a quick shout out to last week's shirt giveaway winner, Rodrigo. We appreciate you so much. And for those of you who don't know, Rodrigo won the giveaway within 5 minutes of the video being up. So shout out to you, thanks for your support. You're the best, we're rocking with you, and we want to see you rep SPR everywhere you go. Shout out to you, bro.
So once again, from your boy Benny G Buckets.
And George, aka Sticks.
Yeah, it's pure love, only one way. Push what up, nigga. Whoa, two flow, two call, a name. Tell her